Hey guys, Billy Davidson here with Davidson Pressure Washing and Painting. I want to talk about surface cleaners, things that you should know about your surface cleaner to keep it running perfectly and keep you making money the way you should be making. Last thing we want is a surface cleaner to get out there on a job site, skipping and jumping around and hobbling and wobbling all over. That's not good deal. Also wanted to mention the job we're working on today. I got it off of a yard sign. So if you're interested in how we do our yard sign strategy, please check out the link in the description and it'll take you to our resource page. Scroll down where you can find how we make tons of money with yard signs, put them in particular areas. So we want to know how to fix these, what makes them do that, and a few other important things you need to know about. So as you see, a surface cleaner is exactly what it is. It cleans a surface. We clean surfaces with high pressure using a pressure washer. So a pressure washer mounted on this trailer, you can perhaps actually hear it running, powers water through a hose, through a gun assembly, and down to this swivel here, causing it to turn really fast and clean the concrete. It's basically like having two pressure washing guns under here spinning for you. That way you don't have to work as hard. That's how it works. Now, a couple things that can go wrong with these surface cleaners is these surface cleaners can wear out. These little swivels or unions right here are very disposable. Sometimes they last six months. Sometimes they last a year. This one has happened to last about 3 years. We've gotten lucky. But it may go out in the next few minutes, but we'll know that when it's bad is when we start to get a lot of slack in our union here. This one does got some slack. It's been used quite a bit, but it's still spinning, still working. Also, another way that you can know that your surface cleaner is bad is if it is spewing water out of the union right here or the swivel. These can be rebuilt, but those are kind of hard to redo. So usually we just have a spare swivel in the truck or we know where we can get one right away. So the spare swivels are generally about a third of the price of the surface cleaner. So it's good to have that spare swivel around. So water spewing out of these unions right here would let you know that you have a bad union. Also, another symptom of having a bad union or swivel is this thing not spinning whenever you pull the trigger. You pull the trigger and it stops spinning and water is squirting out of the two nozzles perfectly, but it's not spinning. But when you let off the trigger, you can still come in here and spin. You pull the trigger and it won't spin. What that is, there's something going bad in the ball bearings in your union or your swivel causing that pressure. As soon as that pressure hits it, it kind of seizes up and it won't spin. But when you let it off, then you can spin it. That's let you know you have to change out the swivel. Now, a couple other things that you could be occurring that you just need to change out the tips and not the swivel would be if the surface cleaner is wobbling or bobbling around, not cleaning very evenly. Oftentimes, that's just a symptom of the spray tips being clogged up or broken. Oftentimes, you just want to spin these out, maybe take like a tip cleaner. Sometimes I've used a bread tie, just kind of clean them out, blow them out, flush them out with water, put them back in, and usually that fixes the issue. If it doesn't, you will need to get two new surface cleaners or however many surface cleaner tips your surface cleaner has. So always have a set of spares, whether you have a two setup like this or it's a three setup. Some surface cleaners have four tips. Always have a whole set of spares nearby where you can just put them all in new and be up and running. Now, the surface cleaner tips I recommend, guys, this is very important. Always make sure you match your surface cleaner tips with the flow. If you have 4 gallons per minute, your tips would be 1502. If you're running a 8 gallon per minute, your tips would be a 1504. The 04 is 4 gallons per minute per tip. The 15 is the angle of the spray pattern that comes out of here. So think about that. Make sure you match that up. A lot of guys do have trouble matching up the spray tips and they don't get them right. And it makes their machine work really hard, or they can't clean it right, and oftentimes they don't have their surface cleaner tips matched up to their flow. So check out certain websites where you can buy these surface cleaners and they have charts to get you through. So guys, again, thanks for watching. Everything you need to know about a surface cleaner, part 2. Again, I'm Billy Davidson with Davidson Pressure Washing and Painting.